I'm having a look at this amplifier that I bought a while back. It was featured in one of my mailbag videos, and so this was quite a cheap device. It was £10 I think I spent on it. I think you can get it for less than that from various Chinese vendors, and on the face of it, it looks quite nice. It's got a aluminium, you know, this aluminium section it lives in, and we've got the speaker posts here, the inputs, 12 volt inputs, it runs off 12 volts, and some silver controls on the front. Now I had to open it up because I accidentally broke the on off switch, you see, so the shaft has broken off the on off switch, and I thought I might have to bypass it, maybe solder the pins together or something, but it seems to be I pushed it in, it seems to be locked on, so I think I might just do without the on off switch. But it seemed quite a good opportunity to have a look around while we had it open, and so there's a couple of things that I wanted to call out. So first of all, on the actual electronic design, so this here, this is the 4558, which is a stereo preamp. So it's using a stereo preamp chip. So this is the preamplifier section here, and the main amplifier is this thing here, the TDA7057. Now I had assumed that this was a Class D amplifier. Now a Class D amplifier is a digital amplifier that uses the duty cycle of the output to actually make the sound, and so Class D amplifiers appear a lot in you know, like pocket equipment, like phones these days, because they're cheap and they're very efficient. So I'd assumed it was a Class D amplifier, but this thing here, the I think this is an old Philips chip, the 7057, seems to be discontinued now. So this is a conventional amplifier, so maybe a Class AB. I'm not exactly sure what the architecture is, but it is, I mean, they used to be a lot of these type of chips back in the day with the two rows of legs, and the giveaway is that it's got this metal section on the back here. It's meant to be strapped to a heat sink because it produces a lot of heat. So in this case, it came wrapped in this little bit of aluminium, and it's actually screwed to the side of the case. So, and there was a bit of potting compound in here. I'm not a potting compound. I mean heat compound here. So when I reassemble it, I'm going to put a bit more on, make sure there's enough thermal contact between this and the side of the case. Yeah, so this is a nominally 10 watt amplifier, I think it was, but when you run it at 12 volts, it produces 5 watts. So it's actually much less than the original, you know, sort of information online specified. But that's okay. I wasn't looking for a particularly powerful amplifier in any case. Right, so that's one thing. I need to put some more potting compound on here. Another thing that's a little bit disturbing is this this electrolytic capacitor here, which looks really sort of dirty and a bit corroded, and it doesn't have any markings on it. And it looks for all the world like it might have been pulled out of some other equipment. It's just really ancient. So I'm going to whip that out and find a new one in my box of components and put that in instead, because otherwise this is probably going to fail in a fairly short time, I would guess. So I'll swap that out. The other thing is, you can see here the volume control is kind of mounted on this plastic light pipe. So you've got these two places here where LEDs can go and shine the light through here so that it illuminates the front panel, kind of thing. But let me show you the choice of, see that, so this is one of the LEDs here, so they've got an LED mounted here. Let me show you the choice of LED that they made. So we've got 12 volts here. I'll just switch that on. Now look at that, isn't that the most annoying thing ever? So they've got this multi-function LED that changes colours and it flashes violently, pulses different colours. It's really, really awful. So I mean that LED might be useful in some application, but this one is going to be desperately annoying, I think. So I'm gonna swap out that LED. And while I'm at it, you can also see on the circuit board on the other side here, there's room for another current limiting resistor, and there's another place marked out on the board for a LED. So obviously you can mount another LED in here. You know, they've kind of cheaped out and only put one LED in. So what I'll do is I'll find two identical LEDs and I'll mount them either side and finish the job properly. So let's get started and make those few changes. I'm going to start by getting rid of this capacitor. So I think it's these two here. So yeah, look at that. I mean, it's really dirty. It looks like it's been in some piece of equipment for about 100 years, doesn't it? So let's measure the value and then we can find something similar. 1.4 millifarads. Okay, it's a fairly large value. And just look on the board as well, see if there are any clues. It does say 2200U there, so I think we're looking for something around 2000 microfarads. So I'll go and have a look through my box and see what I've got. So I've got 1000 here, 25 volts. I think that will do the job. So let me put that one in. And the next job is to whip out this LED here. I'll find some replacement LEDs. I think I might just go for green actually. See if I can find some nice gentle green LEDs. I found these green LEDs here, so these big ones. I'll show you what the light from these looks like. There you go, so that's quite a gentle green actually, which is what I want. So I've got two identical ones of those. I also have this smaller one here, 3mm LED. I noticed that the light pipes actually have a hole where the 3mm LEDs actually fit in the hole like that. But I'm thinking that maybe it's better to have it perched actually on the, I can show you, to have it perched on the end there. I think maybe that will give a more diffuse light across the light pipe. So I'm going to go with the bigger ones, I think. And I've got, I couldn't find a 1.5K resistor, but I've got a 1.3, so I'm going to put that over here for the second LED, for the current limiting for the second LED. So let me just put those components in. Okay, so everything's back together again now. So we've got the two new LEDs installed. We've got the switch, which seems to be jammed in the on position. I might cover up this hole, so I'm going to do without the power switch. I don't really need it anyway. And the heatsink, so I put some heatsink compound on here. I've reassembled this so that it will make good heat contact with the side of the case, which of course is made out of this extruded aluminium. So you'll see I've plugged some wires in here. I've got the output speakers here. I've got the input, which is coming from this MP3 player. So we'll give it a try. Oh, I should show my speakers. So these are quite nice. I've got this couple of Pioneer speakers from the local dump. So I was able to save those from landfill, and they're quite good. So let's power on. And I'm thinking this shouldn't get too hot, just with the test I'm doing here, but I might check it in a moment. So let's play some copyright free music from YouTube. Good. Okay, it's pretty loud actually. It sounds nice and clear. It's not getting too hot. Okay, so I think that's a good buy. I mean, for £10 or so. Okay, I had to make a couple of repairs and replace that that horrible capacitor. But that's good. So I'll reassemble that. And there's one last thing I should show you. There's a bit of a bubble in the plate here. See, there was this bubble. And I thought this might be, you know, sometimes metal covers come with a see-through protective peel-off plastic layer. I thought that's what was happening here. So I started peeling it off, but it seems to be taking the metallic stuff off as well, and there's just kind of white stuff underneath. So if you buy one of these, don't make that mistake yourself. You don't want to peel anything off here. Okay, so I'm going to reassemble this now, and I might do a final shot when it gets a bit darker in here later in the day. I might do a final shot with the LEDs on so you can see the effect of the light pipe. But other than that, that's the project complete. And thanks very much for watching. See you in the next video.